presentation of charge percolation mechanism of olefins polymerization has several parts. First, we shall give you a short history of olefins polymerization, then generally accepted insertion mechanism, including 60 years open questions and controversies. Some fundamental presumptions examination is the next part of our presentation. And finally, we shall propose to you a charge percolation mechanism of polymerization, some details about this mechanism, polyolefin structure formation by this mechanism, and finally, we shall give you answers on those open questions. So, it is well known that olefins, ethylene, was for the first time polymerized in 1983 by company ICI from England. But this process was performed at very high pressures, above 1,000 bar. Propylene and other olefins did not polymerize even at high pressure. It is very difficult to liquefy high pressure. That is the reason that many scientists try to found some catalyst, and finally in the early 50s, Carl Seedley and Giulio Natta found this catalyst, and Paul Hogan and Robert Banks another one, almost at the same time. And in the early 80s, Walter Kaminski from Germany discovered metallocene catalyst for polymerization. The most important Seedley, Natta, Kaminski and Phillips catalyst are here listed. Classical CW complexes, both based on titanium, then Phillips catalyst based on chromium, and the metallocene based with some transition metal, mainly zirconium. And all of them has some kind of supports, and some types of co-catalysts sometimes. This is the structure of methyl aluminoxane, MAO, here presented. And metallocene is presented here, this structure. So, initially it was explained that some active center is formed. Those catalysts are indeed catalytical precursors. But the catalyst is formed by transition metal alkylation and empty orbital formation by co-catalyst. This is catalyst with alkyl aluminium or some other co-catalyst. Those transition metal will be combined with the one methyl alkyl group, and some empty orbital will be formed here, and this is so-called active center. Now it is generally accepted the insertion mechanism of this process for polymer chain formation. It was given by Kozy and Arman. There are several types of this mechanism, but what is general story? There is those active center, that means metal with empty orbital and alkyl group. This transition metal needs electron to fill here this empty orbital, and olefin monomers have double bond with four electrons here, so initially they started to coordinate, supply this metal with one electron, and double bond is broken, some four member rings is formed, this bond here is broken, and alkyl group initially was that. Now alkyl group is longer for one monomer unit incorporated here. So monomer is inserted between metal and alkyl group, and here empty orbital is regenerated. So there is also bimetallic mechanism and other variants, but what is generally for all of them? We have some support, metal on the support, titanium, zirconium, chromium, in different oxidation states maybe. There is alkyl group, empty orbital, one monomer unit is added, inserted between R, alkyl group, and metal. Then the second is added, inserted again, and this is so-called insertion mechanism. According to this mechanism, the polymer chain grows like grass from the ground, from the soil. And this is pretty simple, but there are many open questions. what is the exact mechanism of this process? What is oxidation state and structural active center? And many other. What is kinetic polymerization? What is the role of the support? Why extremely high support to metal ratio is necessary? And so on. 60 years, the same open questions. See, this process is very important because almost 100 million tons 100 million tons are produced by this process, million tons of polyolefins. The value of this business maybe is above 100 billion tons per year. Because of that, in the last 60 years, maybe 100 laboratories, thousands of the scientists using the most sophisticated equipment and instruments perform, I don't know, maybe 500,000 experiments to explain this phenomenon, to find the answers. And there is no answer up to date. There is no answer. So evidently, something is wrong from the very beginning. Some initial fundamental presumptions have to be re-examined. So we shall now re-examine those initial presumptions. So, what is the basic presumptions? We have here three basic participants: monomer, transition metal, and support. And the crucial question is, why each participant enters into the process? And generally the answer is, each participant has some problems that are solved by the other two participants. So the mutual cooperation of all three participants is necessary to solve their individual problems. Now we shall analyze what are the problems of each participant. Concerning ethylene, ethylene has problem to reduce its free energy. Some process is possible if Gibbs free energy is has a negative value. And Eric Hunter from ICI is calculated that Gibbs free energy is negative value. That means, he concluded, that there is no thermodynamic limitation. Ethylene can react with free radicals even at low pressures. He concluded that ethylene polymerization by radicals is kinetically limited. That means, in the time interval between collisions with monomer molecules, radicals undergo other reactions which terminate their goal. So the time interval should be reduced between radical and monomer collision. This time interval can be reduced if monomer molecules come close to each other, and monomer molecules can come close to each other by compression of ethylene gas, by condensation from gas to liquid, and by some adsorption on some support. So we shall analyze those three processes. Ethylene compression. Eric Hunter realized that at high pressure polymerization conditions, ethylene gas is so density packed that its density is almost like density of liquids, two times higher than it is higher than the density of randomly packed molecules. That means that ethylene molecules are closed packed, very dense. Second, what he realized is the average density of ethylene molecules is lower than their diameter. See, if ethylene is like ball, diameter of this ball, this diameter of ethylene molecule, is 0.5. But density, this high pressure, the diameter between the molecules and this high pressure is 0.4. That means those balls are deformed, they are squeezed. So he concluded that at this high pressure, ethylene molecules are regularly packed, properly oriented, and deformed. But how they are packed, oriented, deformed, he didn't explain. So we analyze this process, how it is played. Normally, if two metal molecules are interact with each other, normally it is explained usually by this type of the curve, and this is equilibrium position at minimum density, minimum energy. But according usually used model, there is only one equilibrium position. But if you use this model, it was not possible to explain why so high density is obtained in so close packing. Instead of that, we used this model proposed by Ruđer Bošković in the 18th century. So here there are several equilibrium positions. And when we realized this compression by this method, this model, the result is the following one. Here is the pressure, temperature, here is the pressure, and by compression, individual molecules are transformed to this pair, then molecules at some distance, then molecules are transformed to two rotating molecules that touch each other, and finally some oligomolecular clusters are formed. So with increasing pressure, such particles are formed that needs less space for the movement. This is general rule. And this is structure of the compressed gas. And this is structure of the liquid like in ethylene gamma phase. And this is gradually transition from this order to order. But it should be noted here. We gave these articles. You can download it from the ResearchGate site free of charge. RG means that you can download it. So this is for ethylene give evidence, but also we found evidence for 143 other substances, elements, inorganic and inorganic compounds, 140. But Russian scientist Korolev, he investigated this transition directly from gas to liquid. He came to the same conclusion for the structure of liquid, that liquids consist of the linear oligomers and rotating B molecules. He concluded and he testified by 8,000 organic liquids, organic compounds, 8,000, including olefins that are used for the polymerization. So, this information is the most important information in this presentation, that this is structure of liquid and structure of fluid generally. Why the most important information? Because plenty of processes, chemical, physical, biological, and other processes are occurred in a liquid state, processes in the nature, in our laboratories, in the plants. Officially, the structure of liquids is not known. There are some ideas, not clear. But we know the structure of liquid. And this is very powerful tool to analyze these processes. If you know what is the structure of liquid, you can explain what will happen in that liquid. Now we should continue with polymerization of ethylene. See, with the increasing pressure, system is going from disorder to ordered phase. That means entropy of the system is going down. Second, only those blue particles and yellow are not able to polymerize. This pink one and this red one, they can. This pink one is mixed here in beta phase, mixed with this polymerizable with non-polymerizable particles are mixed. And these blue particles are in discontinuous phase. But approaching the critical entropy conditions, those particles that can be polymerized are transformed to continuous phase, this phase transition. And they became continuous phase. And this is so-called percolation threshold in the percolation theory, when discontinuous is transformed to the continuous phase one. According to this theory, maximum polymerization rate should be at this condition, where is percolation threshold. So let's give you some example of what we are talking about. Indeed, ethylene can be polymerized only at low entropy. At high entropy, this is polymerization conditions. Here not possible polymerize. Second, this transition from this order to order is so-called second order phase transition, lambda transition. Indeed, in the case of ethylene, there is lambda shape of this transition. Maximum polymerization rate we expect at critical entropy conditions. There are two examples. Here is maximum polymerization rate, exactly when the entropy is equal to one. One example, second example, there are a lot of more. So entropy of ethylene is very important. See, for example, these four experiments. They are performed in four different laboratories, quite different conditions concerning reactor type, pressure, temperature, method of initiation, and they obtained these are the conditions of ethylene monomer and the polymerization conditions, and density of polyethylene is equal in all cases, despite very big differences. Why? When you look at the thermodynamic diagram, at this pressure and this temperature, in all cases, entropy of ethylene was almost equal. Equal entropy, equal property of polyethylene. This is very important rule. That means it is best to use entropy as condition of polymerization, not pressure, not temperature, but entropy. In that case, all experimental data published in literature fit one common line. Those four examples on this table, this is like one point in this diagram. And what is the next condition very important? In this order, gamma phase of monomer, ethylene, amorphous, low crystallinity, low density polyethylene obtained, having low molecular mass and lot of branches. Contrary, in crystalline, quasi-crystalline monomer conditions, crystalline polymerase condition produced. So there is mother-daughter resemblance between organization of monomer with the organization crystallinity of polymer. Very important rule. Second, what is important? This is very practical diagram for industrial purpose. For example, you want to produce polymer with this density. What conditions you should use? You will read that entropy in this condition will have this value. Then you will look at the thermodynamic diagram, what are the pressures and temperature to achieve this entropy, adjust the reactor at this pressure temperature, and you will obtain this density. I was plant manager 10 years in that plant, and I checked many times this very practical and simple possibility. This is about this story, high pressure of ethylene polymerization. We have published plenty of papers, several tens of papers, and most important are listed here, and you can download it free of charge from the site ResearchGate. Now, second possibility to bring monomer molecules close to each other is monomer absorption. And there are many investigations of olefins absorption on various supports, because this absorption is important for olefin-paraffin separation, hydrogenation, oxidation, isomerization. Even those monomers and those supports are frequently used in polymerization of ethylene and those the other olefins. Polymer scientists almost completely ignore this empirical data in the explanation of this polymerization. Completely ignore absorption phenomena on the support. Only consider absorption and correlation with metal. But here you have one example. Propylene and ethylene and other compounds can be absorbed on silica even in the absence of transition metal. They are absorbed. And this fact cannot be ignored. So let's now present some general rules for absorption phenomena taken from this book. If the support surface is completely free, absorbed molecules occupy all the available space, all the space available. They are absorbed parallel to the surface. But with decreasing coverage of the support, they are transformed from a gas to partly or the liquid phase up to the solid phase. So decreasing available area of the support, gas is transformed to the liquid and solid, to the measured gas, to the measured liquid. So what is the rule? General rule is, with the reducing of free space on the support absorption, by absorption, such adsorbent is formed that needs less space for the absorption. Same rule as in the case of compression of ethylene gas. But there was three-dimensional space in question, now it is two-dimensional space in question. But the same rule. So, there are data for propylene absorption on some support. Propylene molecules is planar one. And initially, at low coverage, short time interval, it is absorbed in such way. This is explained in this article completely. I just made a picture of this. Others at time, some of the molecules are standing tilted at some angle. It's like this. And finally, after enough time, there are self-assembling of this system, and we obtain this situation. It was proved in this article. And methyl group, here is methyl group is on the plane, this methyl group. But finally, after self-assembling, methyl group is above the plane, up. So this is ordering. Second, normal distance between two carbon atoms in gas of propylene is 0.30. During the absorption, it becomes 0.40, even higher. That means double bond is extended. And final extension will occur after polymerization. But you can see, almost final extension is obtained during absorption. 69% this bond is extended. So what is role of the support? Role of the support is to concentrate monomer molecules, to orient them properly, to deform monomer molecules, and to enable contact of monomer with transition retroactive center. Role of the support is to prepare monomer for polymerization. Same role as it is role of the pressure in the high pressure chemical polymerization of ethylene. Exactly the same role. But why support performs this job? Just support likes monomer molecules. No. Support has own problem. Own problems and want to resolve those problems by reconstruction. Generally speaking, from this book, they are adsorbent-induced reconstruction of the support. Some new solid chemical compounds are formed, some oxide layer or some volatile compound are formed. This is generally. In the case of our support for polymerization of olefins, silica, it is known that thermal treatment, calcination and dehydroxylation result in the formation of surface-strained siloxane group. Grafting chromium ions, ethylene absorption and polymerization enables surface relaxation phenomena. This is explained in literature. Concerning MAO metallocents, volatile produced methane and oxide layer is formed. It is well known also. Concerning magnesium chloride and titanium trichloride, it is known that defoliation and fragmentation is obtained. Graphite is sometimes used in laboratory to polymerize by the olefin by this system, and by absorption, the surface area of graphite is reduced from 300 to 60 in one case, the second case from 8 to 6. So there is surface extraction, relaxation of the surface strain. So But most important are the problems of the third participant in this process, problems of transition metal. There are several problems, but the main transition problem is empty orbital. There is no electrons in this orbital. This atom is hungry, he needs to eat some electrons. And monomer molecules offer him the p electrons for p bond. Metal is happy, he obtained one electron, and they are four membranes. And what's happened then? This bond is broken, and monomer is inserted, and what with metal? Again, there is no electron. And what's happened then? Another monomer molecule is absorbed, and so 1,000 monomer molecules is added to this transition metal. And always transition, see, 1,000 per second. Olefin molecules solve all problems. That means it decreases its free energy by polymerization. But what about transition metal? According to this explanation, accession mechanism, metal has never solved all problems. He never fills orbital with electron. So this mechanism is wrong and nonsense. Because the three transition metal is not so stupid to repeat the same process 1,000 times per second and finally and do the favors to olefin molecules and finally he receives nothing. Why it is not so stupid? Because it is empirical fact that transition metal always fill empty orbital during the polymerization. He found a way to catch this electron, to stabilize itself and to deactivate itself. How? That's open question. Second problem of transition metal. Diversity of oxidation states. In precursor, initially, oxidation state of transition metal is almost homogeneous. One of them, plus two or plus three or some of many of them. But during the preparation, oxidation state is heterogenized. There are at the same time at plus two, plus three, plus four, and sometimes plus six. Depending on the type of the metal and method of preparation. This heterogenization is occurred by co-catalyst, aluminum compound, or even with monomer, which is added to the system. So starting from homogeneous, it becomes heterogeneous. And there is tendency to equalize oxidation state. Metal won't oxidize. What we have? We have support with transition metal in mixed oxidation state, plus two, plus four, plus three, highly separated. They want to equalize their charges again. Because, for example, this has two electrons more than this one. This one will be donated one electron to this, and both of them will be stable, plus two, plus three. But this is not possible because they are highly separated and immobilized on the support. But what is a bigger fact? During the polymerization, with addition of monomer, always monomer molecules are deactivated and homogenized to plus three. But how? And how it's happened can be explained by this charge manipulation mechanism that we are proposed to you. What do we have here? We have presented here all participants. We have support. We have some plus two transition metal attached to the support. We have plus four transition metal alkylated and attached to the support. And we have absorbed the monomer molecules. This terminal left at monomer molecule will be inserted here, will be coordinated with this one. This terminal on the right side will be coordinated with this transition metal. And there is clouds of p electrons. All those electrons will be moved to the more positive particle and partially negative charge will be formed here on the right side of this cluster of monomer. This partly negative charge will attract this proton from Archie group, leaving electrons here to the metal. At the same time, this hydrogen proton will be repelled to this one and these electrons will be polymerized the whole system like a domino effect. Polymer chain will be formed, detached from the support, and these two transition metals will be deactivated, became plus 3, and the surface will be available for the further absorption of monomer. This is shortly this charge percolation mechanism. What is this percolation mechanism? It includes all three basic participants, olefin, transition metal, and acceptor and donor, plus four as acceptor and plus two metal as a donor, as a tandem, working at the support in three mutually interdependent acts: olefin polymerization, metal deactivation by oxygen reduction, and support reconstruction. All three processes are mutually interdependent. So, if it is true, that means starting from some concentration of transition metal plus 2 and plus 4, starting initial concentration on the support, after some time, concentration of this should be reduced and this should be reduced, but plus 3 should be increased. And we can expect. And what's happened? Here is experimental data. Indeed, there are lots of such data, but just one example is here. Plus 2 is reduced, plus 4 is reduced, and plus 3 is increased, as it is expected by this mechanism. So, furthermore, active centers are all the time deactivated. That means that during polymerization, with addition of ethylene, less and less active centers will remain on the support. And here is how the active center, concentration active center is changed with time, this line. This is molecular mass, something else. This is experimental data for ethylene polymerization by chromium catalyst. We perform computer simulation of the same process, but based on the discharge percolation mechanism. And this is the result of simulation. You see, exact time of the curve, both from the active centers and both from the degree of polymerization. This is a black line. This program for simulation is performed in our laboratory, and the technical faculty, technology and technical faculty in Novi Sad in Serbia. And this program like this enables to investigate the effects of very different polymerization conditions listed here. The effects on polymerization parameters listed here, and all of them are based on charge percolation mechanism. We can predict how those operating conditions will affect the polymerization parameters, and also we can simulate real experimental data. So we shall give you some example. But before giving you some example, just additional data about this program for simulation. Whole process, indeed, during the simulation procedure, you can follow by on monitor. See, for example, this is situation of the part of the monitor before absorption of monomer. We have some support here. There is small black points, is not easy to see. This is empty sides of the support. Red and blue are donor and acceptor, metal plus 2 and plus 4. And now the monomer should be added. Look at these two, this one and this one. We shall now make some computer animation, not simulation. What will happen on this, between these two? So, we have some support. Then, some donor and acceptor is attached. Now, one by one, monomer molecule is approaching to the support and absorbed on it. It will little take a time, absorption needs a time. It is not instant process. So, they are absorbed. See, this one is coordinated with donor, and he becomes colored as the donor is colored. This is green, not exactly as it should be. This one is coordinated with acceptor, and the whole cluster is under different acceptor. So this one, so those cluster is charged as it is charged donor. This cluster is charged as it is charged acceptor. They want to transfer the charge from donor to acceptor. But it is not possible. One is missing here. Just one is missing. And finally, this one will be absorbed. So the conductor is complete. Charge will be transferred. Chain, polymer chain will be formed and detached from the support, and those active centers will be deactivated. Here became plastic both of them. This is computer animation, but when we add the monomer, you will see here not completely clear, but there is some cluster connected with this one, some cluster connected with donor, some cluster with acceptor, blue one, and this would be red, but not clear here. And there is some also monomer islands here, this black one, not connected to any position matter. This is initial, at the beginning of polymerization, short absorption time, when there is low coverage. Clusters are separated. So monomer is discontinuous phase. There are empty space between them. Some polymer chain can be formed here. So as a consequence of this, short polymer chains will be formed, low rate of polymerization, and very slow desactivation of the centers. But after some additional time, not clearly to see, but very long, the clusters will become infinite. Very high Cefn semi-monomer will be achieved, and very long polymer chains will be formed here, not clearly seen on these slides. So that means long polymer chain, high polymerization rate, fast desactivation, and very high isotacticity of polymer will be produced. So, now let's see some detail for absorption, because absorption is very important in this process. For example, there is experimental data for propylene absorption zeolite, and you see how its curve looks like. This is empirical data. Here is theoretical curve made by this equation or by this computer simulation, and there are some points of this curve. What are the points? Up to this coverage, the monomer molecules is like islands separated from each other. This is discontinuous phase of monomer on the support, and it above this coverage, it is transformed to continuous phase. When it's happened? It's happened depending how monomer are arranged on the support, in triangular or square or hexagonal lattice. This story is nothing new. It is well known in the physics of geometry and of these other percussion theories. Quite new, nothing new. Well known phenomena. As a critical phenomenon. So, approximately, when the coverage is 60, then there is transition from discontinuous to continuous phase. For example, look in this case. 60% coverage is achieved at this temperature after 1 minute, 2 minutes. At higher temperatures, it is achieved, it needs almost 10 minutes. So this is dynamic of kinetics, depending on temperature between 1 to 10 minutes. So, and why this is important, this transition from discontinuous to continuous phase, because this is so-called precollision threshold. We mentioned precollision threshold in the case high pressure polymerization. I'm told that at the precollision threshold there is maximum polymerization rate. Here is precollision threshold, but in two-dimensional space. And indeed, there is such type of the maximum polymerization. This is experimental run. Zirconium is a transition metal. Alkyl aluminium, MAO was support. And this process was performed with a constant quantity of metal, constant quantity of metal, but the quantity of support is increased from low value to the high value. And what you can see in the experimental run, that higher support, higher polymerization rate. And maximum is almost at constant time. There is slight shifting, but very, very constant. We simulate the same experiment on computer, and we obtain the same type of the curves. Again, the maximum polymerization is exactly at 70%. This is a hexagon lattice, where we expect it. So that means at percolation threshold, there is maximum polymerization rate. And there are lots of such examples. Second possibility is to change, to keep the constant surface area of the support, but to increase or decrease concentration of the transition metal of the support. It is very easy to calculate what will be the metal productivity, support productivity of catalyst. That means metal productivity is quantity of polymer produced per unit of one atom of metal or per unit of the support or per 1 gram of the catalyst. It is very easy to make mathematical model for this process to predict how the metal and support productivity depends on this quantity of the support to metal. And it can be seen with the increasing support quantity, this ratio, metal productivity will be higher. Contrary, support productivity will decrease. This equation is derived in these articles. You can take them and they count in the right. So, using this equation, this is for one experimental run published here. This is the result of our calculation. This is the result of the simulation. That means metal productivity decreases, support increases. Calculation, simulation, and this is experimental run. There is the same trend as in the above experiments. Next possibility that should be taken into account is the fragmentation of the support. See, support area is very high, several hundred square meters per 1 gram. For silica, maybe 1,000 square meters per 1 gram. But this huge area is not one continuous surface area of the surface of the support. It is fragmented. If the concentration, for example, there are two fragments. If the concentration of transition matter is very low, then one acceptor and one donor will be formed after preparation here, and here only one donor. One polymer chain can be formed here, but this one, useless. Nothing can be done here because it is alone. There is no another active center. Here is the optimum situation. We have 5 to 6 acceptor donor per one region, and this is too high. This theory, the effect of the active center assemblies, was developed by Russian scientist Kobozev, and it was published 15 years before the discovery of signal natural catalyst. So let's look now how the fragmentation is. If fragmentation is very low, then metal activity is low. But at this moment, this is optimum. And now it falls down. And this is concerning the metal productivity. And this is concerning the support productivity. This is the result of calculation procedure, just calculate. Then we simulate this process, and there are two types of simulation depending what components is first added to the reactor, or second, or third. There are two possibilities, but the result of calculation is almost exact on simulation, generally. See, there is a maximum metal productivity, and there is some inflection point here on the support productivity. Now, what are the experimental data? We have a lot of confirmation. This, we shall present just three of them. This is metal productivity and support productivity for propylene polymerized by this system. If it is polymerized by metallocene, again we have maximum and support productivity, and see, here is this inflection point I'm talking to you in experimental run. Concerning chromium on support ethylene polymerization by this, it seems there is no peak. There is a peak, very huge peak, but here is, because of that, here is a logarithmic scale. It looks like it is not peak, but it is very big, big, big. This is a result of calculation. This is, this is calculation. This is experimental data. So it is completely confirmed what we are talking about. Charge percolation mechanism can also explain the structure of the polymer. We shall give you only two examples, a couple of examples. One is degree of polymerization. That means how much monomer molecules are incorporated in one polymer chain as average value. And what is the distribution, molecular weight distribution. This is experimental data for propylene polymerization by this system. We put the same operating conditions in our computer program for simulation, and this is experimental, this is the result of the simulation. You can see the same trends of the curve. Even this inflection point, this shoulder, is presented in experimental data, but also in simulated data. Very important question for this process is cellular regularity of polymer chain. What does it mean? Polypropylene chain has a spiral shape. But if this spiral is open in such way that all carbon atoms in the backbone are put in one plane, then methyl group can be all of them above this plane, and this is so-called isotactic polypropylene. Maybe that methyl group will be above, below, above, below, above, below. That is alternating. This is syndiotactic polypropylene, and maybe that this methyl group will be randomly distributed above and below the plane. This is so-called atactic polypropylene. This isotactic has the best properties and the most commercial importance. How they are produced, how this isotacticity is produced. According to insertion mechanism, we don't believe to this mechanism, but I will explain it. It is believed that this metal, its ligands, growing polymer chain, and other components here make this empty orbital, but there is cavity with definite size and shape. Such size and shape that metal, having this metal group, can coordinate only on definite way. For example, this methyl group should be on the left side because here there is alkyl group, and suppose it is on the right side, metal will not come, olefin monomer cannot be coordinated. So must be on the left side. When it is inserted between alkyl group and metal, empty orbital, this cavity will be regenerated here. Next monomer molecule should approach to this position, but now with the methyl group on the right side, here left side, here right side. Again, it will be inserted. Now this group, this empty cavity will be formed here. Next will be monomer molecule will have methyl group on the left side. So left side, right side, left side. So syndiotactic chain will be produced. This is according to this insertion mechanism. But in practice, it is not true. In practice, isotactic mechanism is produced with methyl group always on the left side. What does it, and how it is then explained? Maybe after addition of first monomer molecules, this situation is formed, then this alkyl group is wagging to the previous position, and empty cavity will appear here. Then next molecule we added, and all the wagging. So the growing polymer chain is wagging like dog tail. Why? Why dog wags its tail? I know, but it is nonsense for this metric group, alkyl group. Why and how? Not explained. Now, let's see how it is explained by our charge regulation mechanism. This situation we have during the absorption. starting from low coverage and disordered system, higher coverage but still disordered system, and a very high coverage, high order system. If polymerization is performed here, not possible. If it is performed here, then irregular polymer chain will be formed. But here, if polymerization performed this condition, then high pseudotactic polymer chain will be formed. So, according now, because monomer will be connecting the chain as they are organized. For example, according this mechanism, insertion mechanism, it is when the cavity has the main important role. That means, if there is no cavity, no isotactic polymer will be produced. But there are experiments without transition metal. This one. Hirahata from Japan used this boron and aluminum compounds on the support. Without support, there is no polymerization properly. On support, silica was the support. There was the ISO 93% was isotactic production for polymer. What does it mean? There is no transition metal. There is no cavity at all. And he cannot explain how it polymerization performed. But here is where we can explain very simple. We have organized monomer in such way. Support with monomer molecules of such organized, the metal group is up and always on the above side on the support. In liquid it is alternating up and down. But on support is like this, and because of that we have acceptor and donor. This is acceptor and donor on both sides, and of polymer chain will be high percentage. What will be happen in the polymerization is without support in liquid. In liquid it have this structure. I told you, this is diagram for ethylene, and this is structure of liquid ethylene. But I told you, we checked for the 143 substances, and it is value for all the substances. Only different pressure and temperature coordinates are. But the quality is the same. So propylene has the same quality, the same structure. There are clusters of linear clusters of propylene and two molecules of propylene. In such mixture, in this linear cluster, there is no support. It is more convenient to have alternating, this alternating group. This is more convenient because it is the minimum steric hindrance in this structure. And in that case, we can expect more pseudotactic polypropylene to be produced. In any case, some of them will be pseudotactic. We were able to predict. Here is some example in this article, in this patent. This is what we predicted structure of the polymer by our mechanism, and this is experimental data. You can see that concerning isotactic bonds, atactic bonds, syndiotactic bonds, molecular mass of the polymer, and molecular distribution. And quite good agreement is obtained. And again we have mother-daughter resemblance, like we had in the case of high-pressure free radical polymerization. Here also, high-organized mother, high-organized isotactic polymer will be produced as its daughter. So, finally we shall make some conclusions. Conclusions is answers on those open questions remained 60 years open. Mechanismization, we explain the terminal molecules are coordinated, terminal molecules of monomer clusters are coordinated with plus 2 and plus 4 beta. Mechanism, charge percolation mechanism. Oxidation state of lactic center should be plus 2 and plus 4, but as a tandem, no one of them, both of them at the same time. Then, structure of the center depends on the type of the metal. Are active centers uniform or non-uniform? again repeat, M2 plus 2 and plus 4 is tandem. Thus, alkyl aluminum compound participate in active center. It alkylates, reduced, and form metal cavity. It is important for sometimes. Kinetic polymerization must include adsorption and percolation processes, because by insertion mechanism, those processes are not taken into account. From the support we explained very extensively, why extremely high support to metal ratio should be. Very simple explanation. If two metals are close to each other on the support, polymer chain will be this long. If the support is high surface area and they are more separated on the support, longer chain will be support. Very simple explanation. So, higher distance between transition metal, high molecular mass, and more polymer will be produced, because more monomer molecules have to be absorbed between these two active centers. What is the role of electron donors, hydrogen, and MaO? So can be explained by the discharge percolation mechanism, but this is not now. It's another time we should speak about that. And origin polymer structure, shortly. Monomer organization is responsible for the polymer structure. Finally, there are several of my collaborators working in this field, and I'm grateful for them, but also I'm very grateful to plenty of my students, which analyzed published experiments and simulated by charge percolation mechanism. Finally, our recommendation. If someone wants to continue to follow this insertion path, he will have a lot of trouble. We recommend to take another path, percolation path. Why? Because there is nothing more practical than a good theory.